Hi guys, today I'm gonna go through downloading and installing Google Earth Pro so we can go over the export to Google Earth of your project from Trimble Business Center. So in your browser, just type in Google Earth Pro and you should get to the web page, which is google.com Earth versions. Obviously, they have the new product called Earth. So there is this new product called Earth. However, we want to install a desktop version of Google Earth Pro, which became a few years back, became free. You don't have to pay for it anymore. So scroll down until you find the download Earth Pro on desktop. Hit, download, okay. Accept and download, and your download should be done. Double click the installer and it's gonna ask you to accept because it's not the proper publisher or whatnot, so we'll hit yes and there we go. So again, depending on the speed of your internet, it might take from a couple of seconds to a couple of hours. So there's a couple of prompts. Okay, installation complete. So once you hit the close button, it will turn on your Google Earth. There are some startup tips. I'm gonna uncheck that so I don't need to see that anymore every time when I start up. And you can start zooming in to the areas wherever you want. So let's pick once you hit the little N, it will rotate the map to point to the north. Oh, here is a Salt Lake City. So let's zoom into a little portion on here on left hand side. You can turn on the roads. That's always a nice thing to see. Places, I turn off unless I need it. As you can see, there is the 3D buildings are turned on. You can turn that off by clicking over here. It's a nice feature, especially the big populated cities, they have it. One thing I want to bring up here, which is really sweet, is when you zoom in to certain place and you click down here on this year, it will bring up this sidebar. So you can go all the way to 1985 up to basically 2020 and look at the different imagery from Google Earth, right? Different imagery from Google Earth. Now, some of it is nice, some of it is not as pretty as the latest images, but it will give you an idea. Even when you load in your project, you might, especially in the remote areas, sometimes they have like a winter forest only. Let's go fly into my country here, into Canada. There we go. So if you go somewhere into out in the boonies where there is not much population, you see, for example, these clouds. Now, your project might be right there, so you can't see it. So if you go to a different period of maps, you'll be able to see it without the clouds, for example. And problem with that is the further back you go, the imagery is going to be less resolution. So that might not be what you're looking for. It's a really nice feature to see. Hope you enjoyed this quick tutorial. Hit like, hit subscribe, and we'll see you next video when we learn exporting to Google Earth.